Greetings, Skywatchers, and welcome to the sky above us. I'm James Albury, and I'm your tour guide to the night sky. February is Black History Month here in the United States, and I want to share some history with you about a star pattern that helped guide hundreds of people to freedom. What am I talking about? Let me show you. The Big Dipper is a star pattern that has captivated skywatchers for thousands of years. Since the majority of Earth's population lives in the Northern Hemisphere, the Big Dipper has made its way into the folklore of a variety of cultures. To find it, let's set our sky for 9 p.m. on February 15th, facing north. High in the sky, you'll see seven bright stars that form the familiar pattern of the Big Dipper. The four stars, Dubhe, Merak, Fecta, and Megrez, make the bowl. Right next to them are the three stars, Alioth, Mizar, and Alcade. They mark the handle. The Big Dipper, however, is not a constellation. Astronomers refer to it as an asterism, which is a pattern of bright stars in a much larger constellation. In this case, Ursa Major, the Great Bear. The Big Dipper has had many aliases throughout history. For example, the ancient Maya saw it as the giant macaw and celestial troublemaker Vukubkachix. According to legend, he was placed in the sky by the hero twins Huanapu and Ixchipalanque after the macaw arrogantly claimed that he was the sun and the moon. In China, the seven stars of the Big Dipper formed the right wall of the Purple Forbidden Enclosure, a celestial barrier that surrounds the North Celestial Pole. In Germany, it's called Großer Wagen, or the Great Wagon. In Finland, it's called the Otava, or Salmon Net. In Ireland, it's a farmer's plow. In Northern England, it's sometimes called the Butcher's Cleaver. In France, it's a casserole, and in Holland, it's a saucepan. In the southern United States during the 19th century, the Big Dipper was often referred to as the drinking gourd. At this time in history, slavery was legal in the southern United States. Slave owners were often brutal to their slaves, and many families were separated from each other and sold. Araminta Ross was born into slavery in March 1822. She later changed her name to Harriet Tubman. She was an abolitionist and later a political activist. Harriet escaped slavery and made multiple trips to rescue approximately 70 enslaved people, including several of her family and friends. When Harriet Tubman was helping slaves to escape, she used a covert yet well-established network of anti-slavery activists and safe houses called the Underground Railroad. Families would escape in the middle of the night and travel to these safe houses on their way north, their ultimate destination being southern Canada, where there was no slavery. Since people of that time didn't have GPS devices like we do today, or readily available compasses to find geomagnetic north, they relied on the stars to help them navigate. Back in the 19th century, people knew the night sky very well because they didn't have streetlights to wash out the stars. Therefore, to maintain their northward bearings, they told each other to look for the drinking gourd and keep it in front of them as they traveled. That piece of advice led many people to freedom, and they even made a traveling song called Follow the Drinking Gourd, where the lyrics of the song mentioned many of the landmarks travelers would encounter on their way to the Ohio River, the designated pickup point. So, let's take a look at why the Big Dipper is so good for celestial navigation. The Big Dipper is what we call a circumpolar asterism. Circumpolar means that this star pattern circles the pole. Earth's axis of rotation is pointing in this general area of the sky. Therefore, as Earth rotates, our viewpoint of the Big Dipper changes. The star Polaris is very close to this point of rotation. We call this point the North Celestial Pole. And if you use Dubhe and Merak, you can draw a line that leads almost directly to Polaris. Therefore, during the course of the night, Polaris remains fixed in position while the other stars go around it, making it a great beacon for those trying to find their way. All right, my friends, get outside and look for the drinking gourd, casserole, wagon, plow, cleaver, macaw, dipper, in all its glory. Before you do, make sure you click on the subscribe button below. The Big Dipper will thank you for it. And if you'd like to support our program, click on the Patreon link in the description, and you could qualify for the Sky Above Us memorabilia, and you could see your name in the credits of our next episode. The drinking gourd will lead the way, as long as you remember to keep looking up.
Thank you.